Yeah, not too many news. All the players who were involved also in the last game day are available also for tomorrow. And yeah, that's more or less it. Yeah, sadly, he will miss the game tomorrow. So he's not available because of his calf problems. It's improving from day to day. We have to wait. I hope to have him available for the Luton game. Yeah, but will be also a late decision. Sadly, we'll miss him tomorrow. But that's what you have to handle sometimes during a season. That also some really important players, key players, also players who were in a good shape and was in a really good shape, are out because of injuries, illnesses, whatever. It's for each and every club the same. And yeah, sadly, he's not available for tomorrow. No, not for me. So it's just another opportunity to win 1 or 3 points to edge 1 or 3 points closer to what we want to achieve in the end. Yeah, we are facing a really good opponent, good club, good coach, good players. So a bit different in comparison to, for example, our last game there. We faced a opponent who was fighting against relegation right now, also an opponent who is also fighting for the top six, fighting for the top two. Yeah, good team. We are respectful, but I wouldn't interpret too much in it. Yeah, for us, it's a normal game, a chance to add a few more points under our belt, and that's the situation for us. Yeah, of course we knew about Ivan Toney, so of course we followed his way, but I don't speak too much about what could have happened to our rumors or speculations or players we should have signed or could have signed or whatever. And I never speak about our scouting or how close we came to sign a player or something like this. So we just speak about when we sign a player and that's it, and not about all the possibilities. Of course, he's a good, really good player, no doubt about this. He's proven this during the season so far. He scored many goals, unbelievably important for Brentford. And yeah, one of the topics is of course also to control him, because of course he's a key man for them. But in general, so Brentford is a really, really good side with many offensive threats, with a really good approach. And for that, yeah, we have to make sure that it's not like we just have to control one player. We have to control all of them on the pitch, and that's our task. Yeah, I've spoken about this. So in order to be absolutely safe, if you want to be in the playoffs, you have to have 80 points. And with 90 points, you have a good chance anyhow to be there in the top two. And I always spoke about this. So our first claim is to achieve as quick as possible 80 points to make sure there is no doubt about the playoffs. But probably a few lesser would be already also enough. But just with 80 points, you're 100% clear. And if you have achieved this and there are a few games left, and hopefully there are a few games left for us after that, then you go for more and you can speak about more. But it's more like step by step. So this league is so relentless and momentum can change so quick. So we are, of course, happy. Yeah, in terms of points, we're playing the best championship season in our whole history, if I'm honest. It's fantastic. Yeah, 2 years ago, we were there with the best championship reason of all times for Norwich City Football Club. And at the same stage 2 years ago, we had 7 points less. Or right now at this stage, we are, I think, 11 points more than Leeds, for example, who was praised a lot last season. We are there with 11 points more than Leeds in the last season. So it's fantastic what the lads are doing, but it's also about to keep going. So we need to win as many points as possible also from now on. And yeah, good opportunity to tomorrow to add another points also to under our belt. If I'm honest, I don't want to talk too much in public about this, because I always got the feeling, so yeah, when some coaches are speaking about their relationship to world-class coaches, it's a bit more like fishing for compliments. Yeah, just because I've got a good relationship with Pep Guardiola, it's not a proof that I'm a fantastic coach or something like this. So yeah, of course, Pep is one of the best coaches in the world, if not the best. You know how much I also like his approach and his style and how he influenced the game. He's fantastic and a big inspiration for so many people in this business. Also, what he has done in recent years, and he was always ahead of the wave. Also, yeah, he has played with a false nine, but no one was speaking about a false nine anyway. He was there with dominating possession when everyone was just speaking about pressing. He has played with fullbacks in the middle of the of the park when no one would even be able to think about this. So he was always a big inspiration for many, many coaches, for many people in this business. And for that, he's a world-class coach. But I don't like to talk too much in public about our relationship. We have a really good and close relationship. Yeah, of course, my fingers are also crossed for him. I know that he follows quite closely Norbert Schütte. He has made it public that he spoke a bit about how much he really likes us, also us to watch us, and we have quite a good relationship. So he made it public, and yeah, there are worse comments. And if one of the best coaches in the world likes what you're doing at the football club, it's good for us, and also also good for Norbert Schütte. But I don't want to talk too much in public about our relationship. And I think he's a fantastic coach, a fantastic person, anyhow, and great that we have a good relationship. I don't want to talk too much in public about like how we discuss about football and about our philosophy, because otherwise it would be more like fishing for compliments from my side. Yeah, because Pep is without any doubt a world class coach, one of the best coaches in the world, and I don't want anyhow to be there in the spotlight just because I've got a relationship to Pep anyhow. So yeah, of course we're both football coaches, both more or less addicted to this game, and yeah, also yeah, there are perhaps some similarities also in our approach and in our style, but also some differences definitely. And yeah, of course, when there is sometimes time, and also like, of course, you discuss also a little bit about this topic. But again, so really, I don't want to go too deep into this topic. If I'm honest, Ipswich Town is not that much my topic, and don't want to comment all the speculations or all this developments in the recent weeks or months too much. So I've got respect for each and every club. I think also with Pokuk, I've got a really good relationship. We had also nice talks when we were always also faced each other a few times or so on championship level. I think he's a really good guy, really good coach. He has proved this at Wigan. And yeah, of course, also Ipswich Town with a great reputation is also always good for the competition when you have a bit rivalry and there are some derbies anyhow. Yeah, of course, you wish more or less for each and every other football club also that they are successful there, because you don't want to win football games just because it's easy. Yeah, you want to have this competition anyhow. And it's also good sometimes to have some derby. So also for us, we have always pretty long away travels in order to have some games. But if I'm honest, I'm not too excited at this moment anyhow. Yeah, to face Ipswich Town next season. If I'm really honest, I would rather face Manchester City anyhow, and would look forward to have a glass of wine after the game with Pep. If I'm really honest, although Pokuk is also a really good coach and really good person, and wish him all the best at Ipswich Town. Yes, Kieran is also capable to play in such a role. We have done this also a few times. During preseason, if I'm honest, he's a bit more number 10, and this is also his privileged role and his best role, I think, in general for his game. But of course, he can also play a bit like a false number 10 from the wing. With him, it's a bit the same topic like with Ronel. He was, I think, Kieran was pretty impressive during preseason, had a good start into the season, and then he was out for such a long time. And then, especially for a creative player, it's not easy to come back into a side. Because he was out that long anyhow, and he's a really good lad. He's working unbelievably hard in training. He had some solid and good performance when he came in, also some performances, a substitution where you could see that he's a bit rusty, but there's only one answer. You have to work unbelievably hard on the training pitch to be prepared when you get your chance. And I'm quite convinced that when there is a chance for him also to be in the starting lineup or to have perhaps even a few more minutes, that he can impress even a bit more. But for that, he has to work unbelievably hard, impress also on the training pitch. And I'm quite comfortable that after a bit unlucky season so far for him, and no one can be blamed for this because he was not responsible that he was injured. We were not responsible for this. It was just an unbelievable nasty tackle against him when he said he has had his injury. I'm quite comfortable and confident that the upcoming weeks and months are more possible for him to shine during this month, because he's a good lad. He works unbelievably hard. He's a good character and has also lots of potential. He just needs to get a bit rhythm in order to find his confidence back. also a bit difficult, yeah, because it's not like you just can focus on what is the best for one player, because we're on the final stage of the season. So you always have to face a bit on, okay, what is the best in the team for the team at the moment? For example, with Kieran, I know if I give him 4 or 5 games in a row in the starting lineup, he would be back in his best rhythm and he could shine anyhow. I can't do this there because at the moment the team is even more important than just any individual situation. And for that, he knows that it's a bit difficult for him, yeah, because it's not easy when you're not in the rhythm and you just get 15, 20, 30 minutes then to shine straight away anyhow. But Kieran totally accepts this and he's a good lad and he also thinks just about the club, just about the team anyhow, and he understands this, and I'm quite confident that he will shine in the future for us.